The mission of the 172nd Airlift Wing is to provide strategic airlift for America and Mississippi to support combat and peacetime operations. Based adjacent to Jackson International Airport at Allen C. Thompson Field, the Air Guard facility is named after Charles L. Sullivan, a former Mississippi Lieutenant Governor and longtime pilot in the 172nd. The history of Mississippi military aviation is a rich one. It began as the 183rd Tactical Reconnaissance Group in the 1940s. Since that time, the unit has flown many aircraft and continues to remain on the cutting edge of Air Force technology. Today, the unit has grown to more than 1,200 officers and airmen, a testimony to the success the unit has had in recruiting and retaining qualified professionals. The Jackson-based unit has a reputation of contributing significantly to the economic posture of the city and surrounding communities. The 172nd has received 10 Air Force Outstanding Unit Awards for exceptionally meritorious service. It has twice been awarded the Major General John J. Pesch Flying Safety Award while amassing over 200,000 accident-free flying hours. The unit has effectively demonstrated the ability of the Air National Guard to fulfill its role as a part of America's Total Force Initiative. The unit has flown countless missions in support of our national interests. In 1988, it was the first Air National Guard unit in the United States to participate in the airlift of more than 3,200 troops and almost 1,000 tons of cargo to Honduras. In the same year, crews flew the first C-141B into the earthquake-stricken Soviet Republic of Armenia. In 1989, the 172nd flew relief missions into the hurricane-battered island of St. Croix. In January 1990, the unit flew 21 sorties in support of the operation to end the regime of General Manuel Noriega in Panama. The 172nd's support of Desert Shield Desert Storm was intense and would include thousands of flying hours in the effort to liberate Kuwait. In the year 2000, Mississippi Guard members were called upon to respond to the terrorist bombing of the USS Cole. Aeromedical components of the unit returned injured sailors from Ramstein, Germany to United States soil. The attacks of September 11th in 2001 brought an increased mission load and heightened security to the unit. In 2002, the unit teamed with its sister C-141 unit to operate in a European strategic deployment. Flyers amassed over 4,500 flying hours that year as they relieved crews for high-priority missions during Operation Enduring Freedom over Afghanistan. For 2003, the unit was in conversion status with facilities, air crews, and personnel being trained and prepared. One of the most significant changes to affect the future of the 172nd was made public by Congressman G.B. Sonny Montgomery in November 1995. Congressman Montgomery, in a national news broadcast, announced that six of the U.S. Air Force's newest, most flexible cargo aircraft, the Boeing C-17 Globemaster III, will be assigned to the 172nd Airlift Wing. With over 1,100 highly trained traditional guardsmen and a full-time technical force of about 300, the 172nd is superbly ready and capable of meeting the future head-on. The 172nd Airlift Wing has now become the first Air National Guard unit in our nation to receive the new C-17 Globemaster III. With this innovative 21st century aircraft comes increased responsibility for the 172nd as it plays an ever-increasing role as a vital part of our nation's total force. The versatility and durability of the C-17 opens new doors to new missions and new opportunities.
Every time American interests have been threatened, Mississippi National Guard has served.
The men and women of the 172nd Airlift Wing stand ready to soar into the 21st century.
This is not a test. This is reality.